I want to make a correction to something that I said in the last vlog on Tuesday. So I said that if you pay cash for your expense account with Carnival, that you can go to guest services or wherever to close out your account. I do think that you still have to do that, but they don't give you cash back. Like, they don't give you back your cash. You actually have to wait for them to mail you a check after the cruise is over. I'm going to repeat, you're gonna have to wait for them to mail you a check after the cruise is over. And now that I'm thinking about it, I believe it was Leslie who corrected me on that. Hi, Stacey. Yeah, I think it was Leslie who corrected me on that, but I remember when I did my first cruise in 2011. Hi, Kath. That I had to wait for a check to come back. And you guys remember, like, me telling you guys about that cruise, I barely even, like, made that one financially. So when they were like, we're going to be sending you a check, I was like, what? Like, a record scratch? What? So, yeah, I had to wait for my money to come back to me. It's not like I had spent much to, like, put much on that expense account card. But, yeah, I was a little, I felt some type of way. So, for those of you who are considering giving cash when you check in with Carnival, instead of putting your expense account tied to a credit card, you're gonna have to wait for a check to come to you if you have any money left over off of that card. So yeah. Also, I did confirm that gratuity is included with what you pay, like when you buy drinks and stuff, but there is the option for you to tip more. So I did confirm that. So yeah, so before I get started, and I promise this is not the real reason why I'm late, it just, this is how it worked out. You guys may or may not be able to tell, but I have a different hair color. My hair is different. Yeah. Gotcha. Okay, guys. So, yeah, I mean, you guys do whatever you're most comfortable with as far as, like, that expense account, whether it's cash or credit card, or maybe it's a mixture of both. Hi, Sarah. But I'm not telling you guys how to live your life. I'm just telling you what works for me. I opt for the credit card option, and then I just put a card on file that isn't, like, my main card, and then I transfer money onto that card as needed. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Leslie. Thank you, Natalia. Thank you, Bailey. Hi, Sarah. So, yeah. So, hi, Kath. Yeah, she has a good point. Leave tips for the steward or the stewardess who's taking care of your cabin. I wouldn't just leave the cash laying out, because if you do that, like, they're such good people, they probably aren't going to take it. So you would probably have to, like, literally leave it on your bed with a note that says, this is for you. Please take this cash. So yeah, thank you, Kat. Thank you, Sarah. So this is going to kind of lead me into the topic, one of the topics that I'm going to be covering later on in this evening's vlog. I promise I'm going to have a little bit of something for everyone. But you guys know every now and again I have some topics that are kind of niche, like the plus size fashion stuff that I talk about. And then tonight's vlog, one of the topics is going to be for people that have ethnic hair. So I was trying to find I don't know why I was trying to be politically correct about it. I'm black. I can say whatever I want. Girl, if you got black girl hair, here's what you need to know about how to cruise. So yeah, but also, like, if you have just, you know, coarser hair or curly hair, or if you're not used to the humidity that we're going to encounter in Miami and in the Caribbean, I have some tips for you guys. Okay, so y'all got some, like, good, like, there's some good tipping information to find in the comments. Yeah, so definitely go look at the comments, whether you're watching this vlog live or if you're watching it later on after it's already up. So, yeah, so let me go ahead and get this little niche topic out of the way. So if you guys watch, I want to say it was the last vlog. No, it was the vlog from Thursday of last week, I kind of gave away my little secret. So yes, I've changed my hair color, but I didn't change my hair, like color. I changed my hair. So this is a wig. This entire, all of this is a wig. I kind of had to rush because it came today, and I'll try to show you guys a picture of what it looked like when it arrived, because it did not look, the color and everything was the same, but as far as like how this looks, it did not look like this. And because it's brand new, I still have some customization work as far as like styling and like making sure that it like is how I actually want it to look fully. Like I'm still working on cutting layers into it, but I had to stop. And then my iPad decided it was gonna get screwy with me, so I had time to cut a few more layers in it, but yeah, I was kind of struggling. So just so you guys, for those of you guys who are new to the vlog, can't believe I'm about to do this, but whatever, I'm gonna do it. Hold on, I'm coming back. I didn't get kidnapped. I should brush this before I show it to you guys. So, yeah. This is what I've been wearing in all of the vlogs since I started. This one that I'm holding up in front of you guys right now. So when I say that the whole thing was a wig, I'm serious. I like this one. However, I got red because my boyfriend told me that he liked redheads. We were out to dinner somewhere and he saw some lady with this color and he was like, would look really good on you. And I was like, okay, I mean, I'll think about it. But then he was like, something you should know about me is I kind of have a thing for redheads. And I was like, okay, I mean, I could probably pull off red hair. I'll give it a shot. Everyone loved it. He loved it, of course. All my friends loved it. My coworkers loved it. People that I would just like run out. I would just be out and about running errands. And no, Shayla, it is not a sew-in. but yeah, people would just compliment me out on the street and they loved it. And it's not bad. It's just it never quite grew on me. You know what I mean? Well, because it wasn't growing out of my head. It's a wig. But no, it just this color just never quite settled with me. I'm going to keep this one because I might want to, you know, I don't know, I might be doing a cosplay one day where the person I'm pretending to be is a redhead, or it was a really fun color for fall because I got this one in September of last year and wore it all the way up until today when this one came in the mail. So for those of you who are wondering, first of all, let me just dispel a myth about wigs right now. So this is what's called a lace front. So basically it's lace, not like lace pattern that you would find on like clothes or something, but the material is called lace. Actually, I have some that I cut, because when you get these, you have to cut the lace off of the front and off of the back. And I'm gonna do a more in-depth explanation of how this works when I start my own personal vlog, which I made that announcement today. But this is, I don't know if you guys can see it, this is what the lace looks like. And this is lace that was attached to the front that I cut off. But where my hair starts, that it's attached, it's sewn on individually, each little individual hair is sewn onto this lace. And I don't know where I was going with that. Anyway, I'm in shock that I'm like telling you guys all this right now. So I guess it's because probably the first video on my personal vlog is going to be a review of this wig. It's from the same company that I buy all my hair from, which I am going to tell you guys. But I wanted to dispel the myth that wigs like this are just for black girls, because they're not just for black girls and women of color. You guys can wear these wigs too. This is 100% real Indian hair. The quality of this hair is fantastic. It feels really good. It's really soft. Yes, Stacey, redheads do rock. Hi, Elaine. My boyfriend would agree with you. Stephanie, hi. Oh, hey, Stephanie Mays. Hey, thanks for watching. But yeah, it's not limited to just one group of people that can wear this hair. Especially if you can learn how to blend it properly with your own hair. it can look really good. Or if you're doing what I'm doing, which is I don't have any of my natural hair out except for like in some of like the edges here. That's like me. But like the rest of it is like totally covered up. And yeah, I still need to do some playing around with this one, like I said. But that's my secret. My secret's out. So where do I get mine from? It's the only place I've ever gotten them from. I've had like 10 over the last... I started wearing wigs in 2013 because prior to that, I had gone natural, which for those of you guys who don't know, that means that I stopped relaxing my hair. And if you're not black, you might not know. I'm not going to assume that you guys don't know, but I'm just telling you just in case you don't. Thank you, Kath. If you don't know, black women will often put a chemical on their hair to make it straight and not so kinky curly. Well, as I've mentioned before many times, I was raised by my dad by himself. I was a child. I was born in the late 80s. The natural movement wasn't a big thing back then in the early 90s, and he was a single father, and he did the only thing that he knew to do, which was to take me to a salon and have them start relaxing my hair. So from the age of like 3 until, I can't do math, 24, 25, I was getting relaxers every 2 weeks. Not every 2 weeks, whoa, that's way too often. Every, like once a month or so, I was getting relaxers. More people started going natural a few years ago. And then the more I started learning about going natural and the reasons why it was good for you, the more I was just like, that's what I needed to do. Also, relaxer has lye in it, which is an ingredient that can lead to Alzheimer's and other issues. And I was thinking, like, I've been putting this on my head since I was 3 years old. My memory is like steadily going. I don't know if it's the relaxer, if it's the internet induced ADD. Like, I don't know what it is, but you know what? I know I can eliminate one of those without too much of a struggle. So I eliminated relaxers. And Margie, yes, natural is beautiful. And I'm natural underneath this wig. My hair is natural and it's really healthy and it's really strong. Now, I went through a struggle last year. That's a different story for another day. But yeah, I was one of those girls who went natural and I had horrible shrinkage. And for those of you guys who don't know, what that means is when my hair was wet or had a lot or has a lot of product in it, it would be like my curls would be stretched out, but as it dried, it would shrink up. And it's like no matter how long I grow my natural hair, the shrinkage is just, it's just ridiculous. Yes, Leslie, yes. Like relaxers are like, they're just not good for you. They're not. So yeah, but I had like these horrible issues with shrinkage. I never really grew the time or the patience to really learn how to properly do twist outs, which for those of you guys who don't know, it's when you take your hair, your natural hair, or you guys actually, you know, white girls can do it too. Hi, Kathy. You can take your hair, stretch it out, and actually there's different twist patterns that you can do and different braid patterns you can do while your hair is wet with some type of like holding product in it, even if it's just like a light mousse or something. Let it dry, typically like overnight, and then in the morning, like unravel it, and you have these, your curls are stretched out and they're manageable because you basically manipulated the curl pattern yourself, right? I just never got the patience to really do it, and I'll be honest with you guys, I never really learned how to braid, to like braids that like I could go out and people could see, like in public. So I just dealt with the shrinkage, and then I was on YouTube. No, I was working my job in property management at the time. I was a leasing agent. And I worked at a property here in Atlanta in an area of town called Buckhead. And if you guys are familiar with Atlanta, you know where I'm talking about. Buckhead is like the Beverly Hills of the South. People there either have a lot of money or pretend that they do. It is not uncommon to be passed on the left going down Peachtree in Buckhead by a Lamborghini and a Bentley and a Aston Martin, like all within the span of like no time at all.